thin and gaunt and white. But he assured me he was feeling a great deal better and that, in fact, it was improving daily.
What sort of condition are in the cell your husband occupies? Is he able to work in it at night, for example?
I understand not. I understand that the... I haven't seen it myself. I don't see him in his own room. But the light, for instance, is high and dim, and he can't read by it. So that as soon as the light has gone from the sky, he can't read or do write or do anything for the rest of the time.
How long is he in his cell?
I understand it's locked. He's locked away from the little courtyard that he's able to have in the daytime at 5 o'clock in the evening. His last meal is at 4:30. And for a civilized and sophisticated man, I think that this is a terrible deprivation. Until 6:30 the next morning, he's locked into his cell.
Is there anything you can do about it?
I don't know. I'm trying to think, and I will do anything I possibly can. They're able to make an appeal, but the appeal is to be made to the minister, who's already made up his own mind about it and has taken the action that he has in the first place, so that I don't really think there's much use appealing to the minister.
Mrs. Todd, why do you think Judith has gone on hunger strike?
Well, I suppose the reasons that she's given are that she wants to draw attention to the fact that the detentions are not in line with the promise that was given in the White Paper that normal political activity would be allowed, and also that evidence that she had prepared for the Pierce Commission has in fact been taken by the special branch.
You last saw Judith last week. What was her health like then?
Oh, she was just her usual very gentle, loving self. But I thought she was nevertheless under a certain strain. She was shaking a little bit, but it was cold, and I thought it might have been that she was cold.